This is Within His Grasp, a Drake Reed FBI suspense thriller, book 2, written by Katie Rush, read by Jack. Prologue. Rebecca Morris's breath crystallized before her, misting in the cold night air as she pounded the pavement of Serenity Park. Her red hair was pinned away from her face, bobbing with each stride in sync with the rhythmic thud of her running shoes against the frost-slicked path. The solitude of the park at night was usually a solace, a safe place where the environmental lawyer could unwind the knotted thoughts of her day. But tonight, an unseasonal chill made the darkness seem deeper, the silence more profound. Her sense of isolation grew stronger as she rounded the familiar bend by the weeping willows, whose bare branches whispered in the relentless wind. Rebecca adjusted her glasses, which had begun to fog slightly. She glimpsed a movement off to one side of the path, and when she glanced that way, a silhouette detached itself from obscurity beneath an ancient oak tree, its outline vague yet disturbingly human. The figure appeared large, wrapped in a heavy coat with a hood. Was it another jogger? Someone meeting a lover? Surely no jogger would stand so still, no lover's tryst would be so devoid of laughter or the soft murmur of conversation. It stood silent and still as Rebecca trotted on by. But there was something unsettling about the way it just existed, not moving towards her or away, simply being there. She thought she should have been home, preparing for tomorrow's environmental case, surrounded by legal briefs and the smell of coffee. Even so, Rebecca reminded herself, Serenity Park was well lighted and had always been perfectly safe. A glance over her shoulder, nothing but darkness and the echo of her own movement. But no, there, was that the shuffle of a footstep? A whisper of movement that was not her own? Then she definitely heard steps on the path behind her. The crunch of gravel underfoot became a duet on the paths. Keep moving, don't look, just run, pulsy, pulsy, pulsy. The rhythm of her heart thrummed in her ears, a frantic drumbeat that matched her hastening footsteps. Was it real, this sense she had of being followed? Or was it just the remnants of her last case playing tricks on her? She scanned for the familiar blue light of an emergency call box, or the comforting glow of a late-night dog walker. Anything. Anyone. Her sneakers slapped against the path, a staccato rhythm that begged for safety. The footsteps behind her persisted, matching her speed exactly. Now every shadow seemed to move. Every sound became a threat. Run. Faster. Now. Rebecca's breath came in ragged gasps as she pushed herself harder, but the figure matched her pace with eerie precision. There was a bench ahead. She knew it hid a narrow path between the bushes, a shortcut she had taken many times during the day. She knew that path well. Now it might be a lifeline. She veered off the path, hoping to lose her pursuer amid the trees, but even there, darkness was not her ally. She soon heard twigs snapping under her assailant's heavy steps as they followed suit. The alternate route provided no respite, merely new shadows for her fears to populate. Her mind raced, formulating plans only to discard them as quickly as they formed. A left turn would take her deeper into the park's heart, a right towards the pond. Neither promised safety. The figure behind her followed, a predator in the night. Rebecca's world narrowed to the pounding of her heart and the desperate need to outrun the unnamed dread that stalked her. She knew she was being hunted. Help! She tried to shout, but her cry was swallowed by the darkness. She pulled her cell phone out of her pocket, slowing down enough to look at the screen, to find the emergency signal. But then her foot caught on an unseen route, sending her stumbling and the phone flying out of sight in the underbrush. Behind her, the soft rustle of movement grew louder, closer, the sound of pursuit that promised no respite. She regained her balance, then ran again, abandoning the phone. A hurried glance behind. The light was too dim, the shadows too deep. She couldn't be sure it was a he, could be inches or yards away. But instinct screamed that he was close. Too close. She pushed herself harder, legs burning with the effort, lungs searing with the cold air. Ahead, the outline of the park's exit teased her, a mere 100 yards away. Beyond those gates, there would surely be traffic on the street even at this time of night. Could she make it? Or was it just another mirage crafted by her frantic mind? Then it happened, A sudden shift in the sound of pursuit. The figure behind her accelerated, a startling break from their measured stalking. Rebecca's heart pounded against her ribs.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.